We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is God by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing, advance Australia fair.
Thank you to the kind souls who left messages of support for our community at the City of Glen Iris Peace Garden. Thank you to those heroic Victorians who have contacted us, offering their homes to Israelis needing accommodation. Thank you to the leaders of other ethnic communities and to the leaders of the Ethnic Communities Council who have joined us here this evening and who have expressed their support for our community and for Israelis worldwide. And thank you to our political leadership, federal and state, Labor and Liberal. Your total and bipartisan support is welcomed by all of us. You have stood firmly with the Jewish community, and we've gone through this together as a result. We are grateful, and your support will not be forgotten. I've had many conversations this week with both the Premier and the Leader of the Opposition. The Premier's concern for our community is deep and empathetic. She and her government have pulled out all stops to make sure we have what we need, from lighting up the city in blue and white to making sure we are safe and everything in between. Thank you, Jacinta. Following her remarks, the Leader of the Victorian Opposition will also address us. John and his team's support has also been steadfast and welcome, underscored by his visit to Bet Weitzman yesterday to check in with the staff there, all of whom have been working tirelessly for our community this week and every week. Thank you too, John. I now call on the Premier of Victoria, Jacinta Allan, to address us, to be followed by the Leader of the Opposition, John Pesutto. Following our state leaders' addresses, we will have greetings from the federal government and opposition through Attorney General Mark Dreyfus, followed by the Shadow Minister for Home Affairs, Senator James Patterson.
I'm honoured that you have invited me here today, and I am deeply moved by the personal stories you have shared over the past week, from speaking with the Rabbinical Council to speaking with people on the street. So many people in this community have told me about their anxiety that they feel for their family, their friends, and for their homeland. I've heard stories that have ended with good news, the missed calls that got returned, the text message that said, I'm okay. And we know, though, that not everyone's story will end this way. I read about a 12-year-old boy, Erez Calderon. He's around the same age as my own daughter, a nice boy from a big family. They live in the kibbutz near Oz, which is a major grower of asparagus in Israel, and they've lived there undisturbed, doing this work for 60 years. All we know about Erez right now is he's somewhere in Gaza, and so is his sister, so is his father and his grandmother. Their status is missing, and Kibbutz Nir Oz no longer stands. One family member of the family said, it feels just like a horror movie that would never come true. And whether they know an Erez or not, perhaps every Jewish person on earth has contemplated that feeling over these past few days. Their horror movie, this unthinkable sequel. Terrorism revealed to us through 10-second videos. It was, as we know, the single greatest loss of Jewish life since the Holocaust. And I unequivocally condemn the terror and the violence we have seen this week in Israel. I cannot begin to imagine the feeling of having to deal with this pain and sorrow. I know I will never truly know. But you know, this community knows. And as Premier of this state, I say to you, I hear you, I feel your anguish. And on behalf of the Victorian community, I offer you nothing less than our love, our care, and our support, and our friendship. And Victoria and Israel have always shared that deep connection, that friendship. It has a lot to do with the similarities. It has a lot to do with this community. I know the friendship will endure today, tomorrow, and forever, because Israel will endure today, tomorrow, and forever. I also know too, as you do, that the next few weeks will not be easy.
The Jewish community. We can't hear anything out the back.
Oh, we can't make it louder.
We can't hear anything
out
here, so you can turn it up.
No, we can't.
The Jewish community. The Jewish community are united by love, but I know you continue to face the world's oldest form of hate. We will stand with you every day. Our government, our society, does not tolerate racism and will never tolerate anti-Semitism. My door remains open to you and your leaders, and I am prepared to offer you any support you need to stay safe on our streets, in your schools, and in your homes. Because every Victorian, no matter who they are, has that right. Everyone in Israel has that right too, the right to safety, to security, the simple freedom to exist, the ordinary ability to live quietly and build something of one's own and not be fighting to survive. That simple private peace that all Australians enjoy is all Israelis want. And finally, it's the hope that Golda Meir described 50 years ago when she said, "We do not rejoice in victories. We rejoice when a new kind of cotton grows and when strawberries bloom in Israel." I hope we will see strawberries bloom in Israel next spring, and I hope we will see asparagus grow again in near Oz. I know the support you are providing to your loved ones in their homeland will make a difference in Israel, and I hope you can feel the love, care and support we have for you, your community, here in Victoria. Thank you and Shabbat Shalom.
A few days ago, we saw one of the worst affronts to humanity that you could imagine. The stories that we have been told of and that we know are true, despite attempts to displace the truth, have offended our very core. Not just those of the Jewish people, but all peoples who love freedom and human dignity and work hard to lift everyone in the common cause of humanity. These acts were acts of terror. They were acts of barbarism. They were atrocities. They were an abomination. And we cannot allow it to stand. But I want to make this point in echoing what Jacinta said. When these acts occur, unless we join with you, the Jewish community here in Victoria, around the country, around the world, in common cause with the people of Israel, unless we do that, there is an even more damaging victory. It is one of fear. As dehumanizing as those awful acts of barbarism were, there is another form of dehumanization that takes hold unless we put up a strong stance. And that is one of fear that leaves people scared to be who they are and to live the lives they want to. And so it is so important, as the days unfold, as we learn more about these atrocities and as more action is taken to confront this evil, we must remember that we must join in common cause to make sure we dispel those fears and we stand strong here today. And as I look at the sea of people here today from all walks of life, not just the proud Jewish community here, but everyone, different religions and faiths,
different racial and ethnic backgrounds, all joining with you, because at the end of the day, my dear friends, we all share that common bond of humanity. And what happens to you happens to me. What matters to you matters to me. You know, when I went to the Beth Wiseman Centre yesterday with David Southwick, despite all I've said about the fear and the acts of barbarism, there was something even greater than that. It was hope. And what I was told about was inspiring stories. One of them moved me greatly. It was the story that supermarkets in Israel have empty shelves because people are rushing to buy food so they can make recipes for soldiers on the front line and to do whatever they can to help in the cause of peace and security for the people of Israel.
I need to get a shot behind you just one second.
I heard of an elderly woman who donated all the money she had to the effort, even though she has unpaid energy bills. What does that tell you about devotion to her fellow human beings? So out of the atrocities of a few days ago, we see the strength and resolve of the Jewish people in Israel, at home, and around the world. Be proud of that and rest assured that we will do everything we can to stand with you. And I want to leave you with this. To all of the young people here, the little kids, the toddlers here, I know some of these things are difficult, but as you look through the audience, you'll see something even greater than any fear, than memories of painful losses. It's the beautiful strength and resolve of people coming together. And know that, little ones, that's what will endure, and that's what will keep Israel strong and the people of the Jewish faith safe the world over. Thank you. Stay strong, everyone.
Shabbat Shalom. I'm here tonight representing the Prime Minister and the Australian government. And I am also here as a member of the Australian Jewish community, Melbourne's Jewish community, our community. Tonight, we mourn the greatest loss of Jewish life in a single day since the Holocaust. Tonight, we mourn more than 1,200 people who have been murdered by Hamas terrorists over the course of the last week. Hundreds of young Israelis mercilessly hunted down at a music festival. Israelis murdered in their homes, shot as they answered their front doors. Israeli children butchered in their beds. Entire families mercilessly slaughtered in their cars, their kitchens, their living rooms. Men, women, and children. Jewish men, Jewish women, Jewish children. Many of us here this evening are the children or grandchildren of Holocaust survivors. I am the son of a Holocaust survivor. And it is unbearable to comprehend how, given all we have endured as a people over our long history, this could be happening again. Spending sleepless nights waiting to hear, desperately to hear from loved ones. So many fearing for the safety of family and friends in Israel, including those being called up to serve. There is no excuse for the atrocities of Hamas. There is no justification. This was not an attack on the state of Israel, and it was not just an attack on the people of Israel. This was an attack on the Jewish people. And it was also an attack on the values shared by all democratic nations, including Australia. Over thousands of years, the Jewish community, our community, has only survived because of our unbreakable spirit in the face of horrific prejudice, and I see that unbreakable spirit here tonight. But this time, unlike so many times in our past, the Jewish community is not alone. Israel is not alone. Australia's support for Israel is deep and enduring. It is a bond of true friendship, which goes back to the founding of modern Israel, when Doc Evatt helped introduce Resolution 181, and to when, under Prime Minister Ben Chifley, Australia was the first country to cast a vote in favour of creating the State of Israel. Tonight, more than 75 years since Australia supported the creation of the State of Israel, my message to you, on behalf of the Prime Minister and the whole of the Australian government, your government, is simple. Australia stands as one with Israel and the people of Israel. Australia stands as one with the Jewish community, and we always will. Thank you.